Hello guys, this is Leo the Wise, giving to all men, their needed uprise.
Hi folks, Leo the Wise here to provide information about a REDDCOIN article from Reddit called, REDDCOIN Antibiotic Nuke, come and feed. It will be in two parts. So this is part number one. Sorry for the inconvenience, but YouTube does not want me to upload longer videos. This post contains a lot of generalizations which embody fundamental beliefs of the red pill philosophy. This list is extensive but not exhaustive. These are bullet points, and thus there is not a case study for every point made, and there is not necessarily an explanation given with each bullet point. This is because this information has been designed to be snappy and easy to absorb, not an academic dissertation on each belief and concept shared. Think of it as something of a partial codification of many different RP beliefs. Feminists claim they want equality, but what they really want is power without responsibility. They desire both male and female privilege consolidated into one, thus upsetting the gender balance. They want the privileges of being women, privilege such as being economically provided for, getting opportunities based on their beauty and protection from physical harm by others, as well as male privilege, authority, respect for having a career, to not be judged so harshly based on appearance, etc., which is neither pragmatic nor realistic. It ignores the biological basis for how the genders perceive each other in the ignorance that everything is a social construct and we are mostly the same, when quite evidently this is not the case. Women are irrational and inconsistent. They have a capacity for logic, but it is not their modus operandi. That is to say that they must exert effort to be logical, as it is not their factory setting. A logical woman is easily baited into becoming emotional. Women are easy to compromise. Their decisions are based on their current emotional state rather than the abstraction of logic. It's this proclivity to change so quickly which causes them to act inconsistently and in contradiction. Women are Machiavellian in nature. This means they are comparatively proficient at being manipulative versus the typical male. The evolutionary theoretical basis for this is due to smaller size and inferior musculature. Women had to learn to use men as tools rather than directly oppose them in a physical conflict, as they would undoubtedly lose in all but very few scenarios. This makes the pronunciation of their strength a propensity to be mentally rather than physically violent. Physical violence is outlawed, whereas mental abuse is not. This allows women to get their way without being held accountable by a system of law. The law does not legislate interpersonal morality to this extent. Where a man's instinct is to hit, a woman's is to do a big shit in your mind instead. Race does not matter if you are rich. A lot of you are small-minded and stuck on the superficial, white, black, Arab, Indian, Asian, whatever. You have a certain perception of the world based upon your culture. Perhaps where you live the white man is God, but no, all racial barriers are overcome by power. Money is power. If you're a 5 Asian with a 2-inch dick, that girl's laugh at a 7-digit bank balance is sure to offset that. Focus less on your race and more on your success. Your insecurities will get you nowhere. The real segregation is between rich and poor, and that is even more true when it comes down to women. Never forget that. Rich versus poor is the only thing that matters in this world. White versus black, West Coast versus East Coast, all these other beefs are a minor. They are all symptoms of wealth inequality. The bottom line is wealth. Rich versus poor motherfuckers. Women are hypergamous. They feel entitled to a superior mate. You have to be richer than her, or at least equally rich. More educated than her, or at least equally educated. You need to be better looking than her, or at least equal looking. You need to be more popular than she is, or at least equally popular. You can offset one area, LMS, looks, money, status, with another. But if you're lower in at least two areas, just forget it. Buying into the last point, this is why 20% of guys are fucking 80% of the chicks. Women date up, mandate down, and yes, this has created rising social inequality since women entered the professions. If a woman thinks she is better than you, she can't respect you. If she can't respect you, she can't love you. Women love men differently to the way men love women. Woman's love is based on adoration. Adoration is a concentrated amount of respect. Respect is derived from power. Be powerful if you want to be loved, or you will never be loved. You will be held in contempt for being weak. Women rely on men to be emotionally stoic. We often call this holding frame. You have to be mentally strong so she can lean on you. She finds that attractive. You cannot lean on her. There is a double standard. If you lean on her, the relationship will fall apart. She will not be able to handle your problems and she will no longer find you attractive. You are a man. You have to be better than her, which means to be stronger than she is. This is why women get to be emotional and we have to be unreactive. We are strong and ignore our emotions so they can indulge in their emotions and enjoy the ride. They find it far more difficult to be logical than we do, and thus it is our burden to be the reasonable ones. Always set boundaries with everyone. Do not be a pushover. This is probably the most important bullet point here.
And that is it for now. If this content was entertaining and interested you, please share, like, and subscribe to this channel. I am the Swan, leading men till dawn, and even beyond. Thanks for the audience.